Hey guys, it's Amanda Panda. I'm so excited for you to meet my elves, Kit and Kat. They just joined me from the North Pole and had a special request. They wanted to be PONIFIED. So today we are going to be creating a custom elf on the shelf pony. Let's start off by making Kit first. He is the boy elf. Now let's get Miss Coco Pomel all ready for her transformation using a little bit of acetone to remove the eyes and any cutie marks or marks on the body. We have to remove all of Coco's original mane because Kit is gonna be getting some cool hair later on. I cut off the bulk of the hair using my scissors, and now I'm going in with the tip of my scissors to just scrape out all of the hair roots and glue, and then just grab some tweezers to pull out all of those chunks from the inside. Now, let's get this transformation started. Using a flesh tone acrylic paint, let's paint Kit's head with 3 layers of color to get a nice opaque coverage. Do you have an elf on a shelf? And if you do, what's its name? I would love to know. So let me know down in the comments below. Now that all of that skin tone color has completely dried, we can start on Kit's eyes. I'm gonna try and make them similar to the original elf on the shelf eyes. So I'm gonna go in with some bright blue and put the eye in the corner, so it kind of looks like he's looking out the side of his eye, very mischievous and cute. But I want his eyes to sparkle just a little bit, so I'm using a pearlizing medium top coat. I'm gonna put 2 layers right over the blue just to make them glisten a little bit. I think that looks so pretty. Now let's switch to a finer paintbrush and outline the entire top of his eye, and then I can switch back to the larger paintbrush and draw in his pupil. Let's make it right here in the corner so that it really looks like he's looking that way, right off to the side. And let's put the little light reflection in the inner corner. Now we have to give Kit his signature rosy cheeks, just like Santa Claus. To do that, I'm using this little custom polish I made. It is clear nail polish mixed with just a teeny tiny bit of red nail polish, and it gives this nice, like, sheer pinky glow. It is perfect for his cheeks, and this is exactly what we used for our Moana pony. Now that all of that painting is completely done and dried, we have to seal in all of our work so it doesn't chip or scrape. So let's cover that with 2 layers of top coat, and once that's dried, we can finally give him his new mane. I want Kit's hair to look just like his regular elf hair. To do that, we're gonna be molding his hair out of Sugru, which is a type of air dry rubber that I just personally prefer over air dry clay. Let's place a large strip of Sugru right down the center of the pony's head and add some extra on the sides to make sure that our hair is big enough and covers enough area. We also need just a little bit more falling right by the ear and a teeny tiny piece right in the front for his little, like, curly wave thing that he has in the front of his hair. The Kit's hair is looking a little bit rough, but we're not done. Using a blunt clay tool, I'm just gonna go in and define the edges of Kit's hairdo and gently scrape off the excess Sugru. The top coat that we put over our paint makes it really easy to scrape that Sugru off. So let's make sure that the sides are a little bit pointy and go all the way down. And there's just way too much hair on the back that goes around his ear, so let's trim that down too and make sure that we do both sides. Now, let's add a little definition to kids' hair using a rubber-ended little tool here. Let's go ahead and press in some indentation so it looks like he has some parts in his hair, and we could even put in little tiny lines so that way it kind of looks like strands of hair. Once all the sugru has completely dried, we can paint his hair. I'm going to be using the shade Dark Chocolate. It sounds so yummy, but you can't eat it. It's a really good match for Kit's regular elf hair. So let's cover this with 2, maybe even 3 layers of paint. Once that dark brown has completely dried, you could, if you wanted to, go in with just a slightly lighter shade of brown and just add some highlights to the indented areas that we made earlier. That's it for his head. Let's get started on Kit's body. It's gonna be relatively simple, doesn't have too much detail to it. I'm gonna be just mounting the body right at the end of my nail dotting tool. It's gonna make it so much easier to paint the entire body without accidentally smudging the paint job. So let's go in with a bright true red color and cover the entire body with 3 layers of paint. For the elf gloves, we could either paint them on using white acrylic paint, or we could put them on using some sugru. Now, I had some left over from Kit's hair, so I thought it would look really awesome if we went in and made these gloves 3D. Let's finish off his body with a new tail. This is the color Toasted Almond from dollyhair.com. It's just a tiny little piece of hair, and we're gonna use a twist tie, and very, very tightly and securely, let's twist tie it right in the center. I cut off the excess of the little twist tie here because the tail hole on this type of articulated pony is very tiny. You can't fit too much in there. It's very different from the regular ponies that I customize. Just gonna place the center right in the hole and then use the end of a paintbrush to push the tail inside of the pony's body. Let's put the pony back together and take a look at our completed custom. Here is our elf on the shelf pony. My boy elf on a shelf is named Kit, so I think we should name this pony Kit 2.0 because he is the second version of my Kit. He looks so, so cute. I found these tiny little Santa hats at Michael's. They are the perfect size for this pony, and Kit number one was nice enough to let Kit 2.0 borrow the little white frilly thing that he has around his neck. Now, we still need to make Cat, who is my girl elf on a shelf, but I was kind of thinking it would be really cool to have an elf on a shelf that kind of maybe looked a little bit like me. What do you guys think? Should I customize the girl elf on a shelf to look like me? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below, and I would love to know if you have an elf on a shelf, what kind of mischief did they get into last year, and have your elf on a shelf's returned this year? Well, that's it for today's custom My Little Pony video. Stay tuned because the girl version of the elf on a shelf pony is gonna be coming up very, very soon. Thank you so much for watching, Little Pandas. Until next time, bye. you can follow me online. To get the latest news and updates, like my Facebook page, facebook.com/MandaPandaToyCollector, or follow me on Instagram at MandaPandaToyCollector. Want to mail me something? Guess what? You can. Mail it to MandaPanda P.O. Box 2855, Humble, Texas 77347.